First thing I'd like to do is introduce who is accompanying me to Stonehill today. First, sitting to my right, we have our city manager, David Wecor. Sitting in the second row, Councilman Wayne Hartman, Councilman Tony DeLuca, Councilman Dennis Dare, and Councilman Matt James. Oh, and Council President Lloyd Martin. I'm sorry, he moved in behind me. I apologize. And we want to thank you. It's nice to be here for the new commission as we kick off the new year 2015. First, I'd like to start, President Bunning. I would like to thank you personally for your letter dated February 3rd, 2015, acknowledging our request to speak specifically about a tax set-off for the town of Ocean City, and for scheduling us today on your agenda to speak on the topic of tax differential. We've made this request on numerous occasions since 2007. We want to thank you and the new commission for honoring our request today. Thank you very much. We arrived early today, so we listened to the requests made by the other municipalities in Worcester County and Ocean Pines, and we're here to support their requests. We also realize, you know, not everything is a one-size-fits-all, and we understand Mayor Morrison's position not supporting House Bill 690, because the current grant system works well for his community, and we support that. But we do support House Bill 690. The town has worked with our citizens to develop our strategic plan. We went through the process similarly described by Mayor Williams a few minutes ago. A couple years ago, we've updated that strategic plan. And the plan establishes our vision. It sets goals and lists our priorities for 2014 through 2015 and beyond. If you look at the strategic plan that I passed out to you on the front page, you'll see that two of our top six priorities deal with Worcester County. And these are priorities developed by our citizens, not just our council. One is to resolve the issue of tax differential, and the other is to improve our working relationship with the Worcester County Commissioners. We think this is a new day. This is a new commission. This is a new council. And obviously, both of those issues are very important to us. And hopefully, today's meeting will open the door to addressing both issues for all of us. We're here today to represent the 28,000 taxpayers in Ocean City. These taxpayers represent approximately 60% of the property tax revenue collected annually by Worcester County. We want to thank the county commissioners for the grants that we have received in the past, but they fall far short of addressing the inequity identified in the tax differential study we had updated in 2013 by the Municipal and Financial Services Group. There's a copy of that study, and we've supplied this to the county, and I'm sure you all have a copy of it as well. This study identifies and supports a tax differential for Ocean City in the amount of $17.1 million. That's $14 million more than the $3 million we received in undesignated grants last year. $14 million. There is also a great disparity in the percentage of grants the total taxes paid received by the town of Ocean City compared to the percent received by other Worcester County municipalities. Compared to the amount of taxes paid, Ocean City gets back approximately 4.46% of the taxes we pay to Worcester County. Berlin gets back approximately 21.96%. Snow Hill gets back approximately 71.10%. And Pocomo gets back 24.3%. Again, we support the other municipalities, but we recognize an inequity this equation. Our letter to President Bunning requested this meeting to discuss tax differential or to work to establish a formula that will resolve the issue. And we've asked that numerous times. Do we expect you to write us a check today for $17.1 million? Absolutely not. But we do expect to move forward. This particular issue has been kicked down the road for far too long. We are determined to see that our Ocean City taxpayers are treated fairly. Our goal is to establish a formula to to resolve these inequities and provide a substantial relief for our Ocean City taxpayers. We have taken the initiative to prepare a memorandum of understanding between Ocean City and Worcester County that will establish a formula to begin addressing this tax set-off beginning July 1st, 2015 and extending through June 30th, 2020. This is our formal request to the county commissioners for the year beginning July 1, 2015. I would now like to ask our city manager, David Reedfor, to give us a few moments to present that memorandum of understanding. And then David and I will be available to take any questions you may have.
Congratulations on your election and to the familiar faces. It's good to see you again and to very familiar faces, commissioner, I should say. So as the mayor indicated, the discussion of tax differential has been probably the number one priority for the mayor and council for the last several years. Each year the mayor and I have a meeting with the president of the county commission as well as the chief administrative officer, and I think dates back to the days of Gerald Mason, and you know, we identify issues and topics of mutual interest, and there have been some successes that have come out of those discussions. The entering into the Mid-Atlantic Amateur Sports Alliance Agreement, the Bayside Park Agreement, and it was a few years ago that we planted the seed about an alternative to a traditional discussion on tax differential, where we suggested the establishment of a formula, a methodology for determining the amount of the annual county grant funding to Ocean City. And that's exactly what this memorandum of understanding does. It establishes a funding formula and a predictable methodology for determining the annual county grant funding paid to the town of Ocean City in lieu of further discussion regarding tax differential and or set-offs during the term of the agreement. As you can see on page 1, line 14 of the agreement, entitled Recitals, I'll spare you the whereas and the because, but the recitals essentially establish the foundation for the agreement. We provided and have provided Worcester County with the detailed financial studies and analysis that were prepared both in 2007 as well as updated by the Municipal and Financial Services Group, which is based out of Annapolis, which identified a number of county services and programs that are not offered to, provided to, and or utilized by the town of Ocean City. And that financial analysis supports the figure of $17.1 million. At the very end, we also recognize and we appreciate the unrestricted and restricted grant funding that has generally been provided by the county. And those include areas of economic development, tourism, the Ocean City Development Corporation, recreation, a visitor bureau, and convention center, as well as undesignated funding, and that amounts to about $3 million a year. On page 2 of the agreement, line 8, this is the introduction to the agreement, and on line 10, number 1, this opening paragraph distinguishes the difference between tax differential and tax set-offs as a means to compensate for double taxation of municipal taxpayers occurring when both municipal and county taxes are levied upon similar or identical services. Sections 2 and 3, lines 18 through 34, are statutory references to the shall counties in the state of Maryland, as well as the may counties in the state of Maryland. Line 36 on page 2 identifies the option of making a payment to municipal corporations to aid the municipal corporation in the funding of municipal services and programs. And generally speaking, that's how Worcester County and has established the funding relationship between its municipal corporations. That's our current approach. Alternatively, the county and one or more of its municipal corporations are also permitted to enter into an agreement that sets out different terms for negotiation, calculations, or approval of tax set-off that are set out under the statutory references on page 2. And that's exactly what this memorandum of understanding contemplates. Line 8 on page 3 begins with the purpose of the agreement. And I'll take you right to, I'd like to reference the table beginning on line 19, which identifies all the municipal corporations in Worcester County. For the period beginning July 1, 14 to June 30th of 15, the percentage of county grants, both restricted and unrestricted, to Ocean City taxes paid, both property taxes and estimated income taxes, equated to 4.56%. Now, there are notations provided on the table. The real property assessments, you'll note that the $8.5 billion figure is actually based on the July 1st, 2014 net assessable real property base per the State of Maryland Department of Taxation and Assessments, per SDAP. We all just received that information from the state. On page 3, on line 1, in addition to the annual restricted and unrestricted grant funding that's provided by Worcester County, the county also provides annual funding to the town of Ocean City for ambulance, our EMS, as well as fire services to the Ocean City Volunteer Fire Department. And this funding is established by specific criteria and calculation methodology. In fact, in the Worcester County Code, in the public safety article, it provides that 1 3/10 cents per $100 of assessed property is set aside for the chartered local volunteer fire departments. And that money is to be equally distributed amongst those departments. We appreciate that funding, and we would like that funding to continue based on specific performance metrics as they currently exist. The MOU does distinguish and point out that the terms of the MOU contemplate a fiscal year relationship, whereas the annual funding for EMS and fire is based on the calendar year. Line 9 on page 4. Again, as the mayor indicated, we are not asking or suggesting that Worcester County take away anything from the other municipal corporations in the county. In section C2, beginning on line 17, what we are asking and what this MOU does is establish a funding formula and a predictable methodology for determining annual county grant funding provided by Worcester County to the town of Ocean City. And that formula is set out in section C3, beginning on line 23. What we are proposing is that beginning in fiscal year 2016, the county shall increase the percentage of annual county grant funding to total taxes paid by the town of Ocean City from 4.56% to 7.56%. The actual amount of the annual county grant funding, which we're calling X, paid to the town for the fiscal year shall be determined by multiplying the sum of A, Ocean City property taxes paid to Worcester County. And again, it's noted that the amount is based on and subject to the State Department of Assessment and Taxation Adjustment on an annual basis, whether that's up or whether that's down. We live by the assessable tax base. This formula is driven by the assessable tax base. So the sum of the Ocean City property taxes paid to Worcester County plus B, the estimated income taxes paid to Worcester County, multiplied times 7.56% in year one. We'd like this annual county grant funding to be considered all unrestricted and subject to allocation and appropriation by the mayor and city council of Ocean City. And based on past practice, we've established a payment date of no later than August 30th. I believe that's consistent with how the grant funding has been distributed. The duration of this memorandum of understanding as proposed is for 5 years. And consistent with any negotiation, and as the mayor indicated, we don't expect Worcester County to write the town of Ocean City a check for $17.1 million. This approach incrementally increases the amount of annual county grant funding to the town of Ocean City by 3% a year over the 5-year term of the agreement. We believe that is a fair and reasonable alternative to get us close to where the detailed financial study and analysis suggest we should be. On page 5, on line 22, again, it also notes that the funding for our fire and EMS and fire departments will continue based on actual performance metrics based on a calendar year basis. Item D, I summarized the suggested term of the agreement, but under item D on page 5, line 34, indicates that the town of Ocean City and the county shall commence and conclude renegotiation of a new 5-year agreement in fiscal year 2020. So in other words, this is the approach, this is the methodology that we would like to suggest, establish, and move forward with in determining the funding moving forward. In closing, I simply would like to tell you that as the legislature in Annapolis takes another stab at the tax differential issue in the current term, as other communities struggle with how to reasonably address the equity and fairness of tax differential and tax setoffs in Maryland, let's be the leaders that we are here in Worcester County. Let's set the example. Let's work together to develop a model for other communities in the state of Maryland to emulate. We look forward to that opportunity. We're here to answer any questions you may have regarding the agreement today, and we look forward to beginning the dialogue. Thank you very much for the opportunity to present to you this morning.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Reform?
Well, I would like to commend the mayor, the city council, the city manager for coming forward with a plan. I've talked about this first, as many of us know, for a lot of years, and this is the first time that a plan has been submitted to move in that direction. So I commend them for that and bring it forward here today.
Thank you.
Mayor, myself, I appreciate this. This is the first step.
Thank you.
You've given us a lot to, this is the first time any of us seen this MOU. We will certainly look at it, and we will be setting up something as soon as possible, I'm sure, to talk to you all about this, and we just appreciate the fact that we're finally, and tearing down that wall, as I heard a couple years ago, which I didn't think there was a wall anyhow.
I think that's exactly what we want to do.
Yes.
And that is exactly what we're hoping for. This is our request for fiscal year 2016. The first year's figure is very clear right there. That's what we're requesting. And we feel that is something that will help ensure the taxpayers of Ocean City do get proper direction from Ocean City. So we thank you.
Thank you, Mayor, and thank you, council members.